the guys, you know, to Branden, who's the leader as a sophomore, and Fatty, and Ryan Smith, who struggled tonight. You know, he's going through those freshman blues, but I'm like, guys, just play and compete on every possession. I don't want 21 turnovers, but I'll tell you what, I'd rather take 15 or 14 turnovers and play real hard all night and not be afraid to make mistakes, as compared to having 4 turnovers and being passive and being concerned about what we're doing, you know, every possession. So, hopefully this is something we can build on. Obviously, Temple's a great challenge on Wednesday night, and once again, that's the Atlanta 10. There's no bun.
Not that the turnovers are good, but when you shoot 47% from the field, you make that.
Yeah, you can. And the fact that, the offensive rebounds that we got really gave us great opportunity for second shots. So I think that balanced things out as well. But our aggressiveness was good, and our defense was fine. I mean, they made some shots, and Taylor, we knew Taylor was going to be a very fine player. He was a really good player at a step back. And we knew he was going to try to take that game over, and he did a good job of it there for a while.
Talk about Brandon's defense on the downstretch.
Well, that's what we did. We moved Fatty off, and Fatty was getting exhausted. He played a lot of minutes, and Dave Duke got in my ear and said, "What do you think?" And I said, "Yeah, because Brandon's length and his experience a little bit." And I thought our bigs did a good job when he got around the basket, really contesting him. I thought a couple of those block shots were great. I was shocked to hear the whistle blow and Kirk went up and blocked that, that one shot down our end. But anyway. That was big, and then Chris Gass is 2 free throws at the end of the game, huge for us as well. So it's all good.
So Coach, you were prepared when Tony started coming at you there in the mid second half. Yeah, 17 points in the second half.
Yeah.
It's just where helping players capitalize.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, we knew we were gonna do it. Now stopping them, I can draw anything I want on the blackboard, on that posy board. It's about getting out there and executing it, being understanding what you're trying to do. And obviously with point guards, it's harder because you can't limit their touches as often because they have the ball in their hands. When someone is playing off the ball, you can face guard them, you can deny them the ball, do some things to keep the ball out of their hands. But with point guards, it's that much tougher.
Talk about Fatty's overall game. Really went back and back with Taylor for the first 25 minutes of the night. Played with a lot of confidence and struggling lately. Can you talk about his game?
Yeah, he has been struggling, and I haven't lost faith in him. I talked to him about just competing. And I thought when he drove the ball, got fouled, and put it off the glass, that was a huge bucket for us. He stayed competitive, and he was fiery. He was up, had his hands on a lot of rebounds, and he grabbed tons today. He had 4, but 6 assists and 3 turnovers, and that's a freshman point guard. That's the guy I think we need from.
Ready? 2 free throws there. 10 seconds left in your spot there.
Coach says it's bare down. He made the free throws. So I was just worried about just not missing at all. So to get the win, it's not
bad. Brandon, you knocked down 2 big threes back to back after George Boston started getting a little bit of pressure on you guys late. Can you talk about what your mindset was? A couple of just spot on the shoe.
Well, Coach was telling me that when I was coming up the screen, they were going under the screen. So I just still had 2 threes that I had done. I just do an outcut, and I'll be open, go for the top. I feel that I was going under twice, and I just had 1 good shot.
I think the last play you channel was going to get most likely good.
Like Coach was saying, he's a good player. I knew he would pull up for 3. For some reason, I knew he would pull up for 3. So I just knew that I don't have to contest it. They're as high as I could. That's a shot.
You guys played against each other in high school?
No.
Oh, you didn't?
What exactly did they do to pick one there?
I have no idea. I couldn't start. I have no idea. Obviously, it's at the other end of the floor, but I didn't see any of us near it. It's funny, on the way off the court, some people here who sit on the floor at that end. So we're like, Coach, nobody on the team is near the ball. Wow. Once again, I'll watch the tape. Look, officials are officials. You can't play without them. Yeah.
What about that home run pass that Gass did late?
Can you put too much to him?
Yeah.
Yeah, he had to come back and make the catch. That's like a tight end in football. You got to really say, run through the pass, come back and get it. He didn't, and Taylor was able to sneak in on him. If he runs through that pass, then it's a foul on Taylor, and didn't go to the foul line.
You okay with the decision there?
Yeah. No, he was open. I think the one he threw earlier trying to get you was too hot, you know. Too much air under it. So he had some space, but then the defender was able to take away that space because the ball was in the air so long. But you have to soften up the pressure, and that does it for us. We just got to get a little more efficient at it.
You said one of your goals here is to make Grosell a hard place for teams to come in. Do you think you've kind of achieved that?
Yeah, we have. It's been a group effort. It's the student body that's here. It's our alumni. It's our season ticket holders. It's just people in New York who love to come to college basketball games. And like I said, I fell in love with the 1 o'clock games on Saturday are awesome. For a coach and a team, you don't have to sit around and wait all day. For a fan, you know, you get up here and especially on a beautiful day like this, walk around on campus, come to the game. People are off your avenue now. It'll be like Mardi Gras for 40 months. They're there after every Saturday game. I think it's great. I also think it's awesome for our older ones. We have a lot of older ones who are season ticket holders. So this time of the day to have games, I think it's very good for them. It's all good. Look, if we hadn't won that game, coach talking all that, I would have been upset and gave it away, but I would have been happy with where we're moving in the right direction. These young guys, they responded, and that's, you're going to get knocked down. I've been through this a couple of times in Hofstra, and built and rebuilt. There's a lot of good things happening. It's because of Branden and the other guys who took a chance and came here.
What's the team's mindset like in the last season?
Buildings, we talk to them all the time, but a lot of things worse than losing basketball games are going to happen to you in the course of your life. So that's how I walk around walking around like the world's coming to an end. Nobody's died. Nobody's sick. Thank God. We just got to go out and get better and work at it every day. And they've been very, very good for us.
How can you build off of it? How can you build off of it like this? What does it look like?
In the next one. That's what you can do. That's how you build off of it. And then, we got to face a really good team. Temple beat Duke every year. They're a real good basketball team and tough and all. So what? We strap it on, and go up there and lace them up and go out and do the best job you can and go compete and get better and play against them. And this team is not going to be striking. We're more than capable of playing at a high level. One of the things we did the other day, and I know once again it's all BS, but they sat and we only watched the Harvard game. For now, our plane got delayed coming back, and we get back at 3 o'clock after the game of Richmond. Myself and my staff all slept here. We got up in the morning, had breakfast, started preparing for this game. The team came in at 11, they watched film from 11 to 12 in here, and we watched the Harvard game. And I said, look at the energy you play in this game. Look at how hard they can be. That's the level you're capable of playing. And maybe that sounded in. They saw how fearless they were playing. And that's what we have to get back to. With young teams, it's all from the neck up. Physical ability is there for the most part. There'll be some nights against certain teams we might be overmatched physically, but that's because we're young. Not because they're not going to be bigger and stronger all the time. Good. Thank you all very much. We appreciate it. Thank you, Steve.